The white matter of the spinal cord consists of ascending and descending tracts, and it's myelinated axons that are traveling together. They have different names. In general, we call the big bundles, the whole area. This is the dorsal funiculus. That's what we call it. Funiculus is the term we use for these great big kind of zones of the white matter. The lateral funiculus is over here, and the ventral funiculus is in here. We'll talk a little bit more about some specifics as we go along. The dorsal funiculus is divided into two columns, a right and a left column. So tracts are named for their origins and destinations, and we have a bunch of ascending tracts. That's information that's coming in from the periphery and going up to the spinal cord. Some of these things are going to synapse in the cord before they go up, and some of them are just going to go straight through. But they're all named for their origin and their destination, and they're carrying sensory information. Descending tracts, same thing, they're named for their origin and their destination, but they're carrying motor information. And some, they're going to come down from the brain. Often they're going to synapse in the ventral horn or the intermediate zone before they go out to the periphery. And they're carrying motor information. So those are the descending. Ascending, sensory. Afferent, ascending is arriving or afferent. Descending is going to be efferent. It's going to be motor. There are going to be regional differences. Obviously, the fibers that are going to innervate your upper arm are not going to be seen in the lumbar portion of the cord. But for the most part, most of your tracts are going to be present at most levels of the cord. But there are some regional differences. So in summary, what I want you to take away from this series of short lectures is I want you to be able to describe the basic plan of the spinal cord gray matter, i.e. dorsal and ventral horns and intermediate zone. Is the spinal cord exactly the same all the way up and down? Yes or no? And why? What types of sensations synapse in the dorsal horn? What types of sensation are going to synapse in the intermediate zone? What types of motor neurons are found in the intermediate zone? What types of motor neurons are found in the ventral horn? Can you describe a funiculus? And how many tracts are there, or how are tracts in the spinal cord named? And if you understand all of these kinds of things, then you will understand and be ready for the assessment.